Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. This video is for people who are still creating many of their database objects using DDS and who haven't made the leap yet because perhaps they still see SQL as more complex even though it really isn't. In addition to the physical and logical files where we change the key of a file, there are some logical files where we can specify a selection of data about the main file. But how can we do this using a DDL in SQL? In this video, I show you how to create SQL indexes using the WHERE clause. Let's go. Well, I have created a physical file and a logical file using DDS. Let me show it to you. This is the physical file where we have three different fields and the key is a unique key, okay? And the logical file, that is this one, let me put it here, is completely the same, but I'm changing the key for the physical file, okay? Now I have this key, that is the field named other, and in this case, the key was number. Well, both files are created and have data inside. Of course, I can use SQL to see the information they contain. So if I go here, and we open a new file, this is what I get. Okay, I have four different fields for this table, okay? Well, also I have created a logical file where I make a selection on one of the fields of the physical file and where I indicate that I want to obtain only the records where that field is greater than zero. Let me show it to you. Is this one? It's not. Okay, is this one? If you see, in this case, I have this table, this logical file that is showing the data by this field in the same way that I did with table 1L1, but I'm selecting only the records where the field has data that is not equal to zero, okay? Of course, if I try to see what is inside, this is what I get, okay? I'm getting only two records because only two records has this field greater than zero, okay? In other videos, I already tried to show how physical files are easily converted to SQL tables using system tools. It is practically not necessary to write anything. Well, I have converted the physical file into an SQL table with the system tools, but with another name, in this case is table 2, and I also created an SQL index by converting the logical file, this one, the number 1, also with another name, okay? Let me show you now how can we convert the second logical file, this one, into an SQL object easily. For that, we are going to enter into schemes. Let's go there. And there we are going to enter into views. It is important to know that our logical files, our DDS logical files, are seen by the database as views and not as indexes, even if they only change the key of a file. Well, let's select the view, that is this one, and let's select generate DDL. Well, after a while, we will see this window. And we have to click on options. Well, there, by default, the program is going to create a view instead of creating an index, okay? And we can change it, just click in here, generate index instead of a view. We can select it, and we can click on generate. And after a while, this is what I get. So the system is converting a logical file into an index and not into a view. And there are advantages about it. For example, we can change the selection, just write in here what we want to do to get. Let me first of all change the table name because I want to change it. I have the table created with another name, okay, for SQL. And for example, we can change the selection. If I see my table, this is the content, okay, so we can change this. Order is different than zero, and number is not equal to 3, for example. Or we can remove this, or whatever you need, okay? Also, we can change the order, descending or ascending, in case we need one thing or another, okay? Well, other advantages about this is, well, first of all, if you are still using native file access in rpgle, if you read from that index, then you will work in the same way as if it was a DDS logical file. Also, in case of a view, as you know, they don't have a key and the information could not be read in the order you need. Okay, in that case, you will need to create an index over the view. Okay, in that case, you have two objects, two SQL objects instead of one. Okay, in case you are programming in SQL, the database engine will use the index when it thinks that the request you are making can be improved using it. Okay. For example, if you are trying to get the information, the data from this table, and in the selection you are doing something like this, where order is different than zero, then the SQL engine will use this index instead of trying to read the information directly from the table. Okay. Well, I have created a simple program using native RPGle file operations for showing you that using these files is completely the same as using DDS files. Okay? Well, let me show it to you. Let's go. Let's close all this. Okay. And let me open the program source. That is this one. Okay. Well, as you can see, the program is not using the cycle. Okay, I'm using a main procedure, and I'm declaring the files inside the main procedures. Okay. And if I do it, I have to use data structures to use the files. Okay, it's the normal way. Well, the declarations are completely the same as they were, as if they were DDS files, okay? And as you see, the read operations are the same too. We are reading an SQL index in the same way we can do it with a logical file, okay? In both cases, in this index, okay? And also in this index where we write the where clause. Okay, so let me compile the program. Okay, it is compiled. And let me open 5250 terminal. We're going to the green screen to see how it works. Okay. And let's run the program. And if I see the job log, this is what I get. Okay, I'm getting the information from the file. First, I'm reading the table directly, so I'm getting four records. Okay. After that, I'm reading the first logical file. Okay, so I'm reading all the four records, 1, 2, 3, 4. But in this case, I'm reading it by the last field. Okay, 0, 0, 1, 2. Okay. And lastly, I'm reading the second logical file, the second index in this case, where we are only getting the information of records that has the last field greater than 0, okay? And in that order, so I'm getting these two records, okay? So as you have seen, the program is reading the files correctly. We don't need to use SQL for using SQL tables or using SQL views or indexes. We can use native operations with no problem in all the cases, okay? Well, also, as you have seen, we don't need to create a view if you only need to make a simple selection of data of a table. And also, indexes are faster than views, okay? Well, I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.